Go? Yeah? Okay. So, there are 30 people in my family. 27 are doctors. 2 infants and 1 chef. No points for guessing who the chef is. So, I've had a very arduous journey. Black sheep is my middle name. But I'm black sheep by choice. So this is a journey I think is worth sharing, and I thought it'll be important for me to share it at this forum to let everybody know where we are and how I've reached here. Let's start all the way back. Did I mention these 27 doctors? Pardon me. Did I mention these 27 doctors are the most brilliant doctors that have faced the earth? My mother is a gynecologist. She's a gold medalist from AIIMS. Gold medalist in AIIMS. My brother is a gastroenterologist, and he's got hundreds of papers that have been published. He goes around the world talking about the functions of the gastronomical system. He gets paid to talk. He gets invited all over the world. My uncle, he discovered a new layer in the cornea. He's essentially rewritten the textbooks. And here I am standing there in rebellious mode saying, I don't want to become a doctor. Why don't I want to become a doctor? Why? The question beckons. Then there are things about a doctor that you don't know. Doctors are on call 24/7. So if you miss the call, there's a good chance somebody will die. I don't want that kind of pressure. Also, I don't think I was meant for, I was not meant for being around people who were dying and ailing. I'm sure there's a crowd that is meant for this, not me. I'm a party animal. I don't want to be around these people. I want to be around people who are healthy, who really want to have a good time, and I want to be part of that celebration. So given a choice, I'd like to be in the party zone, not in the place where everybody is tired and everybody is angry and everybody is sick. So that is the choice that I wanted to make. I wanted good days off, and I didn't want that pressure that if I'm not working on that day, someone might die. So here I am in Rambo mode, with my guns, rebellion mode, with my bandana, ready to shoot that. Listen, I don't want to become a doctor. All of you are doctors. I know you can help me. You can teach me. You can guide me. But I don't want to become a doctor. So all the guns are out, but I have no ammunition. Because what is the second question they're going to ask me? You don't want to become a doctor? What do you want to become? Dude, I didn't think that far. So, from there on, everything that I did and everything that happened to me had strings attached and was going down to that question, what is it that I want to be? At school, I was not a brilliant academician. However, I was very good at art, very good at dramatics, excellent at drawing, sketching. These were things I was fantastic at. These were my strengths. I knew these strengths from earlier on. But I just didn't know how this would culminate into a career. Further on, when in school, there is always a vacation. And part of my family stays at the hills in Missouri. So every time the summer holidays would start, they would ship me off to Missouri with my grandmother. And I'm coupled with my grandmother for the duration of the summer holidays. And I was the second favorite grandchild out of 2. And so why did she take me along to an arduous journey of 6 kilometers to eat a kulfi or to eat chaat? She was the first food I ever met. That was my introduction to a food critic, to a food connoisseur. She would walk past the sweet shop every day and very carefully scanned the entire thing. And what was she looking for? She was looking for the containers that are empty, things that are sold out. And she would remember that. Next time when she wants to order something for her own house, she will pre-order only these two, things which are selling really well. She would know what to eat when, what fruits are in season, and what tastes better at the best time, because she used to walk around in the sabzi mandi a lot. Experience the fruits, experience the vegetables. She had that kind of palate. She would not have a craving just for a kulfi. She wanted to eat the kulfi from that vendor because he does it best. So very early in life, I was taught to appreciate the good things in life. My palate was educated. This combined with the culinary arts gave me a very different perspective in life. I became very choosy about food. I can't just go and eat dal roti. I have to do something with it. I have to eat it in a different way. I have to make it in a different way. I would like to taste it in a new form every day. My expectations were very high with food. I didn't know how to cook, mind you. I had no idea how to cook. But my expectations from food were very, very high. Step two, enter grandmother. My grandmother, from my personal side, is an excellent cook. And I'm once again at the receiving end, eating all the delightful goodies that she makes. She used to make weird pickles. She used to make pickles out of meat. She used to make paranthis out of rice. She also made chewing gum at home once. Should not forget this. I will never forget it. We chewed for a very long time. So that happened. And all of these things are going into my head. Also at school time, I was a Rotarian. And they told me to organize a career counseling for students who were at crossroads and wanted to decide what to do. So I had the opportunity of going to Institute of Hotel Management, calling the dean over, and I had to get a little bit background about Institute of Hotel Management. So that's where I met all these aspiring chefs. And I wanted to ask them, just to get a background and get a feel of the seminar. So I asked them, what is it that you do? What are the working hours like? Is it a fun job? Do you get to eat the goodies? So that person turns around and tells me, fun job, I don't know. So he asked me a very simple question. If you want to celebrate, what do you do? I said, we go out and eat. Yes, that's what it is. If it's a holiday, Christmas, New Year, Diwali, Eid, whatever is it that you want to celebrate, you go out and eat, right? So where do you go? You go to the chef. You go to a five-star restaurant. And there's a chef in that five-star restaurant cooking for you. So you will never get a day off when everybody gets a day off. So if you want to be a part of their party, there's a price to pay. You will not get the days off that you want. New Year, Christmas, forget about it. Diwali. I've not spent Diwali with my family for the past 18 years. Okay? It's always either one day before, and New Year's on every 3rd January for me. Calendar is slightly different in the chef's house. And but then he said something very interesting. But if you like cooking and if you like food, you will really flourish. There is no other place for you. I think that hit the nail on where it should be. So suddenly Rambo had ammunition. My guns are full, my anti-tank missile is ready. And I'm going home and I'm ready with all this stuff. And I'm talking to my parents saying, Dad, Mom, I know what I want to be. I want to be a chef. And what do I see? And what would you expect? You'd expect a pale face, shock and agony. And say, no, beta, what will I do with this hospital? What will we do here? Come on, become a doctor. Your brother is becoming a doctor. Why can't you become a doctor? You're very good. Let's do it. Come on, we'll help you. No, Mom. I don't want to become a doctor. Here we go. I want to be a chef. And they're standing over there with their bulletproof jacket. Nothing happened to them. Unscathed. What did they say? Guess what they said? Do whatever you want to do, but excel at it. Choose anything that you want. Anything at all, but excel at it. Give your 100%. I had no answer. Oh my God, they put the pressure back on me. Listen, they just pointed the gun right back at me. You want to become a chef? Become a chef. Become a chef. You want to cook? Go cook. No problem. What's it to me? I will help you. We will support you in whatever way possible. We don't know how to cook. Yeah? So they pointed the gun right back at me. So what does this, give me? It gives me an additional responsibility. It gives me a freedom of choice. And it tells me that if you have decided to rebel, please take it till the end. Do extremely well. Okay? And further on from there, I joined Institute of Hotel Management. I graduated with the gold medal. I moved on to give a lot of entrance exams for postgraduate colleges, institutes which are in WMI, Waksha. There is one in Taj. There is one with Oberoi's. I got through Oberoi's, which is the most prestigious one. That is a post-graduation course for 2 years. Again, graduated with the gold medal. After that, I moved on to Raj Villas, Uday Villas, Ritz-Carlton, Kempinski. I've traveled the world, China, within India, Africa, opened new hotels from ground up, pastry shops from scratch. I've gone to Italy to learn gelato. I've gone to Belgium to see cacao barri and Calibou factories to see how they turn cocoa beans all the way from Ghana to cocoa paste, hazelnut paste, etc. I've worked with expatriate chefs. I've worked with Michelin star chefs. I've made a career of my own. 18 years down the line, I think the support of my family, and during those 18 years, once I became a chef, the support from my wife and my kids has been really instrumental in shaping where we are right now. Okay, I'm a successful chef. I take care of 2 hotels. However, this would not have been possible had I chosen it very early in life. So my message is that make an informed choice, do all the research that you want, discover your passion and follow it. And if there are parents sitting in this crowd over here, please let them do it. Let them do it. Let them fall. It's okay to make a mistake. It's your own mistake. I own that mistake. Okay? And hopefully you'll rise up from there and become fantastic. Okay? Thank you very much.